Hello everyone, this is Johnny the Orange, and today we're just going to jump straight into some longsword gameplay. This class received the most attention and nerfs last patch, so I'm going to try it out, see if it's still viable or not. The biggest change was to Mercy of Heaven. It's more of a single target heal, it just heals your character up. Doesn't really help your allies or your units anymore. And like all classes, the AoE damage is much less, so the ultimate is affected by that pretty damn greatly. It's still a useful ultimate for its versatility, but the damage is low. If you hit someone at the end of that ultimate after running through a unit, you're going to hit for no damage. Of course, if you're just hitting a single target with that charge, it does still hit for a decent amount of damage as you just saw. But back to Mercy of Heaven for a second, even though it has been nerfed, I still use it. That self-heal is still pretty powerful, not as powerful as it once was. And I'm running that with Paladin and Shield Bash, because when you have Shield Bash, you can follow it up with Paladin. By the time that ends, you can do one shift attack, and then usually the enemy escapes. I did try to add with Vela to that combo, but so easily dodged, it's just not that great of an ability. And the combo I've got going has such a short cooldown, I believe the highest is 10 seconds on Paladin, that you can spam it over and over again. Knightly Vows is now an interesting choice, but I run solo a lot, and in solo, man, your damage is not good enough really to take advantage of that ability. But if I was in a team full of Spears, Poleaxes, and Glaives, it is a pretty damn good choice. You can provide them that speed buff so they can finish people off, and the Mercy of Heavens is only really a single target thing now, it's not really a team buff anymore. So the last patch has made Knightly Vows not seem like a total piece of shit. It is actually viable, and worth checking out. Personally, I still prefer the Mercy of Heavens, it's so reliable. You can heal yourself outside of combat, as in you can be behind some spears and heal yourself, etc. While Martial Prowess actually requires you to be in combat to get that heal. And surprisingly, that's a pain in the ass to do. Mainly because when you're on low health, you retreat so you can't heal, instead of sticking around in the middle of combat trying to get a heal off. You may have noticed the units I'm running this game are all swords, basically. And that is because they do well in situations the longsword does well in, and that is prolonged fights. And what I try to do most of the time is just keep the enemy heroes off my swords so they can get their damage in. Which is rather easy to do with Shield Bash, and you also have your normal attacks that are rather quick and stagger the enemy. As well as just body blocking, stand in front of the enemy when they're trying to AoE and block that shit. Your troops are going to be providing most your DPS, so you want to keep them alive. Also, sword and boars usually last a bit longer than this. I'm just pushing hard, trying to keep the enemy off balance. On this map, it works very well. In fact, I find on any map where you only have two cap points, pushing hard is a great strategy. On maps where you have to capture A, B, then C, it doesn't work as well because by the time you reach the end, you have no troops. So you're better off taking a more conservative approach, not just diving in and taking on like five fucking people as I'm doing right now. As you may have noticed, the survivability of the longsword is still pretty good, especially when I have that sword unit with me. I can dive in and out, get some heals off once in a while, etc. At the moment, I'm also buying my team a lot of time so they can cap A, and when it comes to taking the last point on this map, you can rely on those trebs. So I may be pretty low on the unit count, but it's all good. I've held up these guys. Now we only have that final push to do. Of course, since I have burnt through so many of my troops, I'm going to have to rely on my allies to actually push. And a lot of the time that doesn't happen. Everyone just pulls out range units over and over. Which wouldn't be that bad if they're pulling out good range units, but they're usually pulling out 2-star and 1-star shit. That is useless. The first decent range, in my opinion, are the 2.5 star muskets or the 3 star archers. They're good. Anything below that is complete junk. You're better off bringing some cheap infantry. The Iron Cap Swordsmen are bloody great. Those, was it Pike Militia, I believe, are the 2 star pikes are bloody decent. And then you have the whole Cav line, all that starting Cav, maybe not the horse archers, but the other Cav is pretty good. And then there's always the spears and the sword militia, basically bring anything, but it's low level archers. They suck. They don't really kill anyone, they don't really help push. I'm not sure why you'd ever choose them. But that's enough on that subject. Everyone always asks what my stats are, so while I remember to say what my stats are, let's talk about that. When I play any melee class, I usually go about 50% strength, 50% health. The only exception is when I do play the spear, I just go full agility. The reason being on the spear, most of my damage is coming from piercing attacks, while most of the other melee is relying on slashing and blunt. When it comes to ranged heroes, I just go full agility. Your survivability comes from the fact that you're not in melee combat. The reason I don't put a toughness or armor on the spear when I play it is usually because I'm swapping in and out between the spear and the musket. So I want a build that helps both of those classes, and really, toughness and armor does not help the musket at all. So I just stack agility. So there you go, guys, I finally did cover my stats. I rarely talk about it because I don't think stats are actually that important. Or should I say, it's pretty hard to mess it up. If you go full defense, it's going to work fine. If you go full attack, it'll work fine, etc. The only way you can really mess up is if you go full strength on the longbow or something like that. But back to the game, as you can see, my ultimate just hit that guy for nothing because I hit a bunch of spears before I hit him. So that is something you have to get used to. If you want to get the burst onto the enemy heroes, you can't hit the units beforehand. But it still does have that knockdown effect, and that guy was very low, so I could just auto-attack him. One thing you guys may have noticed, in this patch, the game is definitely more unit-reliant. All the heroes basically got nerfed. So now unit selection is more important than ever. So if I was a new player, I'd go straight for the Iron Cap Swordsman. The first muskets you unlock, the 2.5 star muskets. And the first Lancer Cav, because they're bloody good. I'll still use all those units, because for their cost, they're so powerful. Last patch, the Iron Cap Swordsmen weren't that impressive because for 15 more points you could go the Prefecture Pikes and their charge was just way better. But now AoE damage has been nerfed and the Prefecture Pikes themselves have been nerfed. You can usually get two charges off. On those Iron Cap Swordsmen, you charge into combat and then while they're in combat you charge once again, which in my opinion makes them on par with those Prefecture Pikes. Especially when you consider they're slightly cheaper. 15 points can actually make all the difference. And the Iron Caps have some survivability against ranged unit. When it comes to these muskets I'm using now, they usually pay for themselves, so that's why I use them. And I'll just totally fucking stole that kill. I mean, he was on half health when I started that charge. By the time I got there, he was on zero health. You know, sometimes shit happens. But back to the muskets, they pay for themselves, they sometimes do way better than what their, you know, leadership cost is. Pretty much they're just really reliable, not the most powerful range in the game because of course they're the first muskets you do unlock. But on average they kill definitely more leadership than what they're worth, so it's just a really solid choice. And then you have the Cavaliers, this is one of the other cheap units I do like, it's only 125 leadership. And once again, they pay for themselves. They have a ridiculously good charge for 125 leadership. As for anything else they do, they're kind of crap. So you definitely want to be hitting that charge. And when you do, it usually kills way more than 125 leadership worth of troops. And when it comes to burst damage units or range units, etc., that's what you want. You can't really judge shield walls on that scale because, yeah, they're just pushing up for your team and protecting your team. And they're the other low tier units I do like, no matter if it's the Western or Eastern Spears. The first ones you unlock are very cheap, can protect your team from range for unbelievable amounts of time. And they're great at helping your team push up into those cap points, etc. Providing that wall of protection so they're not just getting shot on the way in. So that's something for new players to think about. Those units are really good and available very early on in the game. I'd probably do another game covering all those units and showing the highlights of what they are capable of. I think I covered all the units I think are good at lower tiers. The rest are kind of, not that great. Especially those low-level bows, I just think they suck nuts. Also, most of the 1-star units or below are just junk, apart from the shields, these ones here. You really have to get to the 2-star stuff to get anything worthwhile. The Sword Militia isn't totally bad, but still, not that great. Once you reach the Silver Era, you just have a massive range of units to select from. And then after that, it's mostly just a bonus. You can unlock new stuff, you can spend more leadership points, etc., and more bronze on repairing them. So you can make a really solid team even before you get to that Silver Era. But enough of that, I forgot I'm meant to be talking about the longsword. It definitely has been nerfed, you can feel that. I didn't enjoy playing this class that much to begin with, even before the nerfs. So the enjoyability of it seems about the same, as in not that enjoyable. It's just too utility-based and tanky-based. I want some damage. You have a lot of utility, you have all these short attacks that stagger people, you have that shield bash that CCs and your ultimate that CCs, and you do still have a lot of survivability. As long as you can block and you're in heavy armor, etc., you're going to have good survivability. Not only that, you can put that slow on people that really annoys them, reducing their speed by 50%. As far as the playstyle, it's still similar to what it was. You can't just shift attack people for 20 years now though, which was where most of the longsword's single target damage did come from. That was a big pain. There's a lot of big pains. I think it might be a slight over nerf, but it's still playable. It's still pretty good. It's just, I don't think it's top tier anymore. But I think what I judge as top tier and what people, other people judge as top tier is completely different. It seems like a lot of people whinge that they can't beat a class 1v1. And that may lead to them nerfing those classes. Which is fine by me, because they're not the classes I usually play. So, I think the problem with the longsword, it was very good in teams and it was the best in duels, well, at least one of the best, but now it's pretty average in duels and it's pretty average in a team. In my opinion, they should have just nerfed either the damage abilities or the healing abilities, not both at the same time. Anyway, guys, that's me done for now. Please subscribe and thumbs up and all that shit, and I hope you liked the video, and I'll see you next time.